Then you get a small, you know, sheep, and then you get something bigger and something bigger. The bigger you get, the more reward you get, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as long as you can afford to do so. So they say, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for every single hair of the udhiyah or the qurban, you get a hasana bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. And then they said, ya Rasulullah, how about the skin? Do we get anything out of that? He said, for every single hair in that skin again, for every single drop of blood, for everything, you get a hasana bi'idhnillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the importance of this udhiyah. أيضاً أحبتي في الله يشهد يستحب من هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في هذا اليوم المبارك أن يضحي المرء إن استطاع إلى ذلك سبيلا وأن يشهد أضحيته وأن يكون هناك إن لم يستطع أن يذبحها هو بنفسه أو هي بنفسها ويسمي الله سبحانه وتعالى ويكبر على أضحيته من نهج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يأكل ثلث أضحيته ويهدي الثلث الآخر والثلث الأخير يتصدق به على فقراء المسلمين يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها ولكن يناله التقوى منكم الله سبحانه وتعالى telling us in the Quran that he will not benefit from anything that we do especially these days when we are offering the sacrifice the udhiyah, the qurbani the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم tells us that you know it is a sunnah that a Muslim, if he can afford to offer an udhiyah, he should slaughter it himself, if he can. If he cannot, he will have someone to slaughter it, but he should be there at the time of, you know, the sacrifice when it takes place, and he should say, you know, Bismillah, and then he should say Allahu Akbar. And it is the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ that when you offer the urbani or the udhiyah, you eat a third of it, and you give away as a hadiyah, as a gift, another third, and the last third, you give it to the needy people of the Muslims. If you cannot find the Muslim, give it to a non-Muslim, your neighbor, if you can do that, if they deserve it. اسمع إلى قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على أهمية الأضحية في هذا اليوم. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما عمل آدمي يعني لم يفعل أي آدمي من عمل يوم النحر الذي هو يومنا هذا والأيام التالية بإذن الله أحب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى من إهراق الدم. من أن يعني يقدم أضحية لله سبحانه وتعالى فإنها تأتي يوم القيامة بقرونها وأشعارها وأظلافها وإن الدم ليقع من الله سبحانه وتعالى بمكان قبل أن يقع على الأرض فطيبوا نفسا The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in this hadith the importance of offering this sacrifice قال صلى الله عليه وسلم there is no action, no good deeds a human being can do In this day of the sacrifice today and the next 2 days, he said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, there is nothing you can do better than offering a sacrifice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because on the day of judgment, it will come with its horn, with its hair, with everything, and the blood, when you slaughter the animal, the blood will get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before the blood hits the ground. This is how easy and how soon it gets to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how quick Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala receive it from you and accept it from you as long as you have the sincere intention for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you expect the great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد
الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين أحبتي في الله What can we do, you know, beside offering the sacrifice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who can afford it. If not, there are many things that we can do as a Muslim, especially in this season, the season of happiness and joy, you know, the Eid al-Adha. The first thing that we can do is always have a sincere and declare a sincere repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single day, if you can do that, This is a sign of a blessing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time you make, you know, a tawbah to Allah azza wa jal, it's a great sign. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in the Quran, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Allah commanding us, the mu'mineen. He says in the Quran, which means, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. So repent to Allah, all of you mu'mineen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not talking about the kuffar right now. He's talking about you and me right now, the mu'mineen who believed in Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that we may have mercy, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may have mercy on us. The other thing is to islahu al-bayn. Man kana fi nafsihi baghdaa aw shahnaa aw idaa baynahu wa bayna akhuhu al-muslim بينها وبين أختها المسلمة هذا هو وقت التصالح والتسامح والعودة إلى الصداقة وتعود المياه إلى مجاريها على كتاب الله وسنة نبيه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The other thing is to fix the problem that you may have between you and another friend, another Muslim or non-Muslim as well. To fix that crack that, you know, someone has created between you and the other friend, you and your wife, you and your husband, your kids. This is a good sign of that. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every time a mu'min meets another mu'min and they shake hands, you know, the sin falls off their hands or their bodies as the leaves fall off the trees. How easy that is, just when you see him, you shake hands, Eid Mubarak, may Allah accept from you and me, you give him a hug and so on and so forth. The other thing, أحبتي في الله هو صلة الأرحام في هذا اليوم. الكثير يحاول قدر المستطاع أن يفعل الأعمال الكثيرة ولكنه للأسف الشديد من جهة أخرى لا يصل أرحامه. والله سبحانه وتعالى قال في الحديث القدسي, من وصلك من وصل الرحم فقد وصلني ومن قطعك فقد قطعني. فإذا قطعت أرحامك أو صلة الأرحام فقد قطعت علاقتك مع الله سبحانه وتعالى والعياذ بالله, وإن قطعت صلتك بالله عز وجل فأنت من الخاسرين في الدنيا والآخرة. The other thing, brothers and sisters in Islam, is we have to get in touch with our kinship, our family members, here or elsewhere, especially the female, the women. We have to get in touch with them, visit them, give them a phone call if they are, you know, far away, get in touch with them, bring them gift, make sure that they are being, you know, they feel that they are cared about. Not just, you know, because they get married and they live, they cannot live far away, that I forget, you know, they forget. No. We have to show them the other way. It is a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, that Allah azza wa jalla said in the hadith of Qudsi, that whoever get in touch with you, whoever is connected with his kinship, his family, he gets in touch with me. He keeps his ties with me. And whoever breaks his ties with his kinship, whether they are in Pakistan or in Yemen, in Syria, in Palestine, elsewhere, and alhamdulillah, there's just a 1 minute phone call. And a lot of time is free. If not, you know, there's a lot of program that you can call your family, check on them, salam alaikum, how is everything? When you keep your touch with your kinship, you keep it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah azza wa jalla continues said, if you break your ties with your kinship and your relationship with them, you break your relationship with me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you break your relationship with Allah, then you are, unfortunately, my, you know, God forbid, among the losers in this life and the hereafter. And أخيرا أحبتي في الله علينا أن نتذكر إخواننا المستضعفين في شتى بقاع الأرض, في إخواننا في سوريا, في فلسطين المضطهدة منذ سنين عديدة, إخواننا الجوعى في أفريقيا, في الصومال, إخواننا المضطهدين في اليمن, في شتى بقاع الأرض, في باكستان وفي غيرها من البلاد, يجب أن نتذكرهم بالدعاء وبالمساعدة, أن استطعنا إلى ذلك سبيلا أيا كانت المساعدة, وأن لا ننساهم, وأن أضعف الإيمان هو الدعاء لهم عند الله سبحانه وتعالى. And finally, brothers and sisters in Islam, another thing that we should remember our oppressed brothers and sisters in many parts of the world, especially in Syria, in Palestine, in Iraq, in Yemen, somewhere in Pakistan, Bangladesh, Afghanistan. In these, there is a lot of Muslim, huge number of Muslim being oppressed as we speak right now. A lot of them, they have no food to eat for today. A lot of them, they have no safety or security. The minimum that we can do, you know, we can do a lot to help them. The minimum is to make dua for them, to remember them, to mention them in our dua, to make sure we feel, you know, the same thing as they feel. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man lam yahtam bi amri muslimin falaysa minhum." Whoever does not care about the mu'mineen, he is not among them. And he said, he is not among us who man bata shab'an wa jaruhu ja'a. He is not among us who, you know, spend the night and goes to sleep and he is full of stomach. He is full, he's not hungry. And he knows his neighbor is hungry, he doesn't have food. So how many of our neighbors, Muslims and non-Muslim around the world, they have no food to eat today? We have to remember them. We enjoy ourselves, alhamdulillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm not trying to depress you, but it just, among the sign of our appreciation to the bounties and the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to think about those who do not have these bounties and favors. And this na'am, appreciating Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also sharing it with those who have, you know, no means or who have no fortune as we are, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. أقول قولي هذا وأسأل الله العظيم أن يغفر لي ولكم اللهم توفنا مسلمين والحقنا بالصالحين اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم يا رب العالمين لا تجعلنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا عسيرا إلا يسرته ولا محتاجا إلا أعطيته ولا فقيرا إلا أغنيته ولا مريضا إلا شافيته ولا مريضا إلا شافيته ولا مريضا إلا شافيته ولا ميتا مسلما إلا رحمته برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم يا ربنا ها نحن واقفون بين يديك نرفع أيدينا تضرعا وخيفة منك يا رب العالمين لا ملجا ولا منجا منك إلا إليك اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وارض عنا واعتق رقابنا من النار يا رب العالمين ووالدينا والمسلمين أجمعين اللهم توفنا مسلمين والحقنا بالصالحين اللهم ارزقنا السعادة في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم ارض عنا في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم يسر أمورنا في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم لا تحرمنا مصاحبة نبيك صلى الله عليه وسلم في الفردوس الأعلى يا رب العالمين اللهم لا تحرمنا لذة النظر إلى وجهك الكريم يا رب العالمين ووالدينا والمسلمين أجمعين أقول قولي هذا وأسأل الله لي ولكم السعادة في الدنيا والآخرة وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وقوموا إلى عيدكم.
Thank you. Yeah.